Asian markets traded mixed on Tuesday. China's monetary authority injected some 100 billion yuan, or nearly $16 billion, into the banking system with its medium-term lending facility. This added support helped offset persistent worries over Ukraine and the Fed's policy tightening. Oil also easing from seven-year peaks. Trading edges Ron Acoba still sticking to his 9,000 index call for the year, despite the headwinds, including a potential rate hike by the Philippine Central Bank later this year. The BSP meets this Thursday.
BSP hiking its rates perhaps in the second half of this year is not much of a concern. Why? Because remember, we're still coming off of a very, very low level of rates, an all-time low. It's actually natural for the BSP or the central bank to increase their rates as the economy recovers from a recession and as the economy enters into a growth phase later on.
Acoba sees corporate earnings growth averaging 15 to 20% this year as restrictions ease and demand comes back, even as the low base effect fades. For the day, the PSE index fell 0.75% to close at 7309. Net foreign selling is at a quarter billion pesos. In corporate stories, Double Dragon Singapore-based subsidiary Hotel 101 Worldwide amends its primary purpose to allow it to acquire, invest, and develop real estate properties in preparation for its first Hotel 101 project abroad this year. Injap Sia and Tony Tancacion's property firm looks to acquire its first property for development into a hybrid condotel hotel outside the Philippines by the second quarter of the year and launch by the second half. Pipeline will be timed with the expected full recovery and rebound of the tourism industry. Double Dragon currently runs Hotel 101 and Tintiang Inn Philippine brands and Ascot in DD Meridian Park, which is under construction. It has 6,165 rooms in its nationwide portfolio. And for the full year 2021, Hotel 101 Manila achieved an average occupancy rate of 96%. And finally, Century Pacific Foods expansion work on its coconut manufacturing facility in Mindanao will finish within this quarter. The 700 million peso expansion project is seen expanding the plant's capacity by 50% and add new lines that will cater to major partners, including Malaysia's Linaco and one of the world's leading coconut water brand, Vita Coco. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.